Alright, welcome to Experiment 3. Today we're going to be learning about a technique called recrystallization. It's a way to purify organic solids. So after Experiment 2, you've isolated your organic unknown, and we're going to learn how to, in this experiment, purify it and then analyze and identify what that unknown compound is. So let's get started.
So recrystallization is introduced in your PowerPoint lecture. You can find this slide that explains how it works. There's also some other general information that you may want to check out on there. So what we're doing today is really just going through procedurally how does it work. There's some other theory and things like that that we won't get into. So what you're going to need, first of all, is a hot plate, and that's warming up some water that you can see there, and possibly a stir rod. That's our unknown, the organic solid that we want to purify. So in there may be some different impurities, possibly in this experiment, maybe sucrose and aspirin. But then in an organic reaction, that might be side products or starting materials. And then finally, an ice bath over there on the right. So we've already done calculations to know roughly how much boiling water we need to dissolve our organic solid. So once you heat this up, you don't want to heat it up to boiling. You want to heat it up so it's warm, but not so hot that you can't pick up the beaker and pour it into your solid.
How much hot solvent I'm going to need, and this solvent in experiment 3 is just water. So I know how much I'm going to need, so I pour in that proper amount. And instead of pouring in just the amount I need, I'm going to pour in a little bit more. That way, during this process, I don't end up having the recrystallization perform or happen prematurely. So since the water I put in there was only about 50 degrees Celsius, I'm going to put it back up on the hot plate, and eventually we want all of that solid to dissolve. So now you can see, after heating this for a while, all of the solid has dissolved. The solution is now near boiling, so hopefully all of our material is dissolved in there. And then once this all dissolves and boils for a second, then we'll be ready to start the recrystallization process. However, if you've tried to heat this and you've added some more solvent and there still happens to be little solids down near the bottom, it's very possible that you've got some insoluble impurities in your solid that you're trying to purify. So if you do happen to have impurities, then what you can do is take a gravity filtration apparatus, so that means a funnel with a filter paper on top of just a normal flask. So if you did happen to have impurities, you could put this on top of the hot plate, let this whole apparatus heat up, and then do a hot filtration of your solution to get rid of those insoluble impurities. In this case, you won't need to use this. So once this is all dissolved, then you can turn off the hot plate and then let this start to cool down slowly. It's that slow cooling process that's going to allow purification of your desired unknown solid. So let that cool down to room temperature, and once it's cooled down to room temperature, then we're going to help it out a little bit. So as this is cooling, you're going to notice that crystals are starting to form. So you can kind of see on the surface there a little bit those crystals that are slowly forming as this is cooling down are purified crystals of your unknown solid. So not only if there were insoluble impurities could we remove those through hot filtration, but then any soluble impurities in this solvent will remain in the liquid while our solid is recrystallizing out. So we'll let this continue to cool to room temperature and eventually put it in an ice bath. Alright, so after this cooled to room temperature, we've got it in an ice bath. We've let that sit there for maybe 5 minutes or so. And now you can see there's tons of solid in there. Almost the whole thing is white. So
we've maximized the yield or the recovery of our unknown, and then any soluble impurities hopefully should still be in this liquid. So at this point, once you've taken your recrystallized product out of the ice bath, you're ready to move on to vacuum filtration. And then vacuum filtration will collect your purified product on the filter paper, which then can be saved in your drawer and weighed during the next period. So that's recrystallization. This is one of the few things in lab that's really more of an art than it is a science. What we just did right there seemed like it worked really nicely, but a lot of times you have to go through a lot of trial and error process to get a recrystallization to work. So if it's a little painstaking, or if yours doesn't quite work right the first time, it's okay. It takes a little bit of practice, but hopefully it gets smoother for you as the semester goes on. So good luck in experiment 3.